Miller decided to take some more time off before returning to the music scene with 1981's Circle of Love. Circle of Love is a strange album. The first half is four simple, easy listening tracks that appear to be a throwback to his early work. But the second half is a single 18-minute long song entitled Macho City. Macho City contains only 3 minutes worth of lyrics, and the rest is every bell and whistle on Steve Miller's keyboard. It is tedious, monotonous, and perhaps one of the most masturbatory synthesizer pieces ever written. Part of the song is just the sound of rain. Seriously. Despite all of this, I actually kind of like it. The first 3 minutes, at least. And it has a pretty funky music video.
They'll be keeping it all legal with political this queen.
Macho City! Macho City!
And Steve Miller was actually pretty proud of this song as well. He kept Macho City as part of his live sets through the 1980s.
Macho City!
And he wanted to release it as the single for the album, but his label said no for two reasons. One, a single cannot be 18 minutes long.
You think so, man?
And two, it was of a political nature.
Time marches through the ages. Macho City!
Macho men always shooting up history's pages.
Macho City!
Taking over this, taking over that.
Macho men always
wear that.
Well, a rather confusing political nature. They went with Heart Like a Wheel instead.
I got a heart like a wheel, feel like I got to roll.
Love was a flop, but his next album was a chart topper. Yes, Abracadabra was a number one hit in 1982, and Steve Miller's last time on top.
It's 1982, and I think Steve Miller Band is like, okay, it's the 80s now, so gotta bump it up a notch, and they came out with Abracadabra. But boy, that was that cheesy.
Steve Miller was cool, and then all this Abra, Abracadabra. It's like, f***. I don't know, good one went down.
Abracadabra is unapologetic pop music, and the lyrics are rather dumb. But honestly, the rest of the album isn't half bad. Personally, I think they went with the wrong song for the single, as most of the album is better music.
I've been digging something up.
Next release was an impressive yet rather underrated live album, which was followed with 1984's Italian X-Rays. Italian X-Rays can be summed up by one stupid image from the music video. Steve actually makes a rare cameo appearance in this music video. He looks confused, and unhappy to be there. I don't blame him. Italian X-Rays has a few decent instrumental tracks, but otherwise, the album is both too experimental and yet still very dull. Miller tried the pop act again with Living in the 20th Century in 1986. It has a couple of decent tracks, but the album is bogged down by excessive filler and 5 covers of old blues songs. 2 years later, Steve did what he had obviously wanted to do from the beginning. He recorded his only official solo album, which was all blues and jazz covers. 1988's Born to Be Blue has not only a stupid name, but it is completely unlistenable. Unless your music taste is really like jazz, you will probably not enjoy this album. Steve and the band made one final attempt at musical relevancy with 1993's Wide River. The title track of Wide River was a moderate success, but the rest of the album is nothing exceptional. At this point, the Steve Miller Band had been certified a nostalgia act. Check out this rare video of Steve Miller expressing a little frustration about this.
They're so conservative, man. You know, you come out and they just love you. You know, you play the Joker and Rockin' Me and Jet Airliner and everybody's happy. Mm-hmm. And they say, now I'm going to do this new song. Everybody just kind of, huh?
You know how that is.
So, but now we're over the hump, and that was the first 3 weeks of the tour. And now they all seem to know it, and it's going over real good. I'm glad to report. Yeah.
From the late 1980s to the early 2000s, the Steve Miller Band has released a host of compilation albums, live cuts, and various re-releases, all of it implying that Steve and the band have decided to accept and enjoy their current status as a classic rock act. For the past 15 years, the Steve Miller Band has toured the county fair and casino circuits, and kept all the crowd favorites as part of the set, filling it out with music that the band just likes to play, truly making the best of their situation. Speaking of the music they love, the Steve Miller Band has just released a brand new album this past summer entitled Bingo, which is another all blues covers album. When I heard this, I was apprehensive, as Steve Miller already did this with Born to be Blue, and that was awful. But at first listen, Bingo is actually pretty good. And the track list is far better than Born to be Blue.
All your love I miss loving, it's an Otis Rush tune. I refer to it as a love rumba. This is a tune that I've been playing all my life.
Yeah, Steve loves that song so much, he recorded it twice. An earlier version of this cover appeared on Wide River. Recently, Steve Miller announced that he will release an album of all new original material sometime this year. By that point, it will have been about 18 years since the last one, so I'm quite curious to check it out. Now we are at the point of the show where I give you my bottom line recommendations. What are his best albums, and what are his worst? Here's top three, bottom three. The top three Steve Miller albums are Fly Like an Eagle, Book of Dreams, and Abracadabra. I know I'm going to get some flack for that, but if you listen to the album as a whole and take it for what it is, it's a cool record. The bottom three are Born to be Blue, Your Saving Grace, and Rock Love. You can throw Journey from Eden in there as well. All four of these albums are subpar anything you should expect with Steve Miller's name on it. Now, if you are a new fan and you just want to sample the Steve Miller Band by getting a compilation album, here are my thoughts. Everyone recognizes Greatest Hits 74 to 78, and with good reason. It covers the bare essentials, but it ignores both his early and later work, like Space Cowboy or Abracadabra. 2003's Young Hearts is probably the most inclusive and the best compilation album, but I personally prefer 1991's The Very Best of Steve Miller, which features some tracks from Abracadabra and a 3-minute version of Macho City. This one is out of print, however, so finding Young Hearts will be much easier. And if you were into live albums, 1983's Steve Miller Live is solid. And the CD from the 2007 DVD Live from Chicago is a good representation of how the band can still rock today. Also, if you're looking to explore one of Steve's more obscure albums, I would check out Circle of Love. Macho City is an interesting song, and the rest of the album isn't half bad. Finally, Steve Miller is musically important. His work in the 1970s was culturally defining for the time, and he has influenced many wide-ranging artists. Some have paid tribute to him by covering his work.
Some people call me the gangster of love. Yeah, and some people walking around calling me Maurice. Cause I speak of the pompous of love.
Abracadabra. I wanna reach out and grab you.
Well, I believe I've said all I can about the Steve Miller Band, and I hope I've encouraged a few people to check him out. He'll be announcing a new tour soon, and he'll probably be coming to your town. My name is Joe, and I want to thank you again for joining me here at Play That Rock and Roll. I hope you join me again next time for more discussion and analysis of the classic rock era. This is Macho City Radio, signing out.
How is he going to rhyme abracadabra with anything? Abracadabra is unrhymable. What the? Grab ya!
Still.